So you've suffered an ankle sprain and you think this is the only way to make it better? In this video, I give you the 5 tips that you must do for a faster ankle sprain recovery. Coming right up. Your favorite trainer here with Athlete Remedy, helping athletes like you overcome injury with the tools to help you take care of your bodies for the long term. And on this channel, I do training and therapy product reviews, tutorials, and ankle sprain treatment videos just like this one. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. So when it comes to ankle sprains, we can definitely agree that no matter how mild they are, they're definitely frustrating and can still hold you back from your sport. So let's get into the 5 tips that you must definitely do when you've suffered an ankle sprain to make sure that you recover faster and correctly. Also, be sure to stick around to the end for a bonus tip on how to get rid of your swelling faster than anything that you've ever tried before. And it does not include ice. Now, the first tip is the RICE method. And I'm sure you've heard of this before. RICE stands for rest, ice, compression, and elevation. But I do want to point out that I recommend a modified method, and I'll get to that in a second. So the first one, rest. Obviously, if you get put into maybe one of these, like an ankle boot, it's definitely a good idea to stay off of it, meaning you're going to have some pain, you're going to have some swelling, and it's important that you don't try to still do the activities like running or jumping, training for your sport that are going to aggravate it if you do this too early. The second one is ice. So icing is something that I only recommend using for pain control. What do I mean by that? Really, if you're in a lot of pain, I recommend doing some ice therapy, maybe doing putting an ice bag on for no more than 20 minutes within that first 24 hours of getting your ankle sprain. Really doing it anytime after that is really not gonna help it at all, and it's really not gonna reduce your swelling. And at that moment, you're actually getting in the way of the healing process. The third is compression. And it's very important to use a compression sleeve. I like using something that is nice and smooth more than the ACE bandage because you tend to get some gaps in there. And so using a compression sleeve that covers from like the base of your foot, right where your toes are, all the way past your ankle and just under your calf is gonna be the safe bet to ensure a nice, smooth, and even compression throughout. And this is really actually going to be one of the keys in getting rid of your swelling. And then E is for elevation. Now it's important that you don't just like have your foot propped up, but that you actually elevate it above the heart. And so this is actually going to be using gravity to your advantage. And what you're doing here with elevating it combined with the compression sleeve, it's actually going to give you the best effect to help minimize that swelling. Now, tip number 5 is movement, because movement is medicine. Now, you might be told that you need to wear an ankle boot for a while, and that's okay. By the way, question of the day, let me know in the comments if you've ever been told that you're stuck in this boot for 2 weeks. Let me know in the comments. What I mean by movement is medicine is that even if you're told that you need to be in an ankle boot for protective purposes, it's important that you don't just keep your ankle in there and hope and pray that it gets better. This is where movement comes in. And what I mean by that is within what's tolerated, you're gonna start doing some circles, really working on increasing that range of motion, because our goal in those first 3 to 5 days within getting an ankle sprain is to decrease swelling, improve range of motion, and get rid of pain. And you'd be surprised how those small movements early on will really make a huge difference in your recovery. I want to also mention that it is absolutely normal within those first 24 to 72 hours to experience pain and increase in swelling, and bruising may also be visible. And I do have a hack for getting rid of bruising a little bit faster, and it's using Arnica. It's a natural cream or gel that you can find, and actually it really helps kind of dry up that bruising naturally. And so if you're interested in checking this out, I'll leave a link below in the description. Okay, so bonus tip. Massage is a phenomenal way to get rid of swelling. This is probably one of the most important, most effective methods that I use on my athletes that gets rid of swelling the fastest. And so if you want to get more of an in-depth tutorial on how to do massage specifically, either with a partner or on yourself, go ahead and click or tap the YouTube card to get more in-depth into that. We talked about the rice method, but modifying the amount of ice that you're using really only within that first 24 hours and really just to control pain. We talked about the importance of using a nice and smooth compression sleeve, talked about the importance of elevating the ankle above the heart, and movement is medicine. Hey, I hope that you found value from this video. If you want to check out more of the Ankle Spray Series Guide, click or tap the screen there. Or for more videos on this channel, click or tap the screen there. As always, I'm Michelle, your favorite trainer, helping you get back in the game. Remember, don't skip recovery. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.